as a book of science, but when it speaks about science, it is right on. Do you know who this guy is? That's not a picture of my dad. That's obviously George Washington, the first president of the United States. Do you know how George Washington died? If you said bloodletting, you would be correct. Because doctors felt that disease was carried through the blood, a common practice in George Washington's day was to drain the blood from people who were sick. When he became ill, Washington's blood was drained, and then he died. Sitting on the nightstand next to the bed Washington died in was a Bible. In Leviticus 17, verse 11, the Bible says, "The life of the flesh is in the blood." Had Washington's doctors consulted the Bible, perhaps George Washington would still be alive today. Okay, maybe not today. But the practice of bloodletting at the time could have been seen as the dangerous practice that it was. The Bible wasn't just a book written by men. God's divine words provided knowledge that preceded even the scientific knowledge of the past. The Bible is a scientifically reliable source of truth.